As we go through this year, we have seen many of our young men and women standing at buildings and houses guarding them. It doesn't mean that they haven't got the brains to go and study. It's just because they never had an opportunity. An opportunity was never given to them to be able to be funded in our institutions. Let's make sure that these young men and women get the opportunity to be able to exercise their minds and to be able to be positive contributors to our nation. Many of our people, as Christmas has dawned, do not have the means to go anywhere. They are in Havanas, they are in Tualolokas, they are in illegal in Ochivarongo, they are in Dama, Makaravan West, and Soner Vater, and also DRCs in Kietmans. But they've got no means of celebrating with you. Think about them. Think about the many women that sit across our hospitals. Think about those women who are delivering the future of our generations, yet they live in tents awaiting to deliver. Think about the many of our people who are in our hospitals without medicine, and yet the doctors and nurses are trying their best to be able to deliver the care. They haven't been given a pay rise for years and years. The same applies to our defense forces. Our men and women in the forces haven't had a pay rise, and yet the prices go up and up. Think about the many people who are today having lost their loved ones. The fishermen who have either committed suicide because of the circumstances that has become unbearable. Many of them have lost their property because they could no longer bear, no longer keep up with the payments. 25 of the fishermen died as a result of the greedy of our leaders to have sold our resources to foreign countries. Think about them at the time that you are enjoying with yourself. Let it be a time of reflection, so that when you come out of this period of holidays, period of reflection, you come out with renewed energy and strength. But at the same time, let's think about what we did in 2014. We elected our president, Comrade Hage King. And surely and certainly, you will admit with me that 2019 was not one of his best years. It was certainly an honest horrible. Let's think about him. He is human. Let's think about him and give him strength to be able to finish his term of office. It is difficult. It is mind-eroding when the people that you entrusted with the task and the sacred task of our nation have betrayed not only the president, but betrayed the entire nation. Let's also remember that as much as we know and heard that the demonstrations and the campaigns of the SWAPO party had the possibility of having been funded with money laundering, let's think about the legitimacy of that outcome of the 2017 Congress. We cannot live with a nation that has been betrayed. We cannot live with a leadership that emerged from money laundering or proceeds of money laundering. We need to make decisions as a nation to clean up and to ensure that there is no betrayal, whether it's in the SWAPO party or whether it's in the Namibian government. The reason why I'm not leaving this party is because it's best to clean up from inside the house than to go outside and clean up. So as we march into the new year, Namibia, think about those who are not as fortunate as you are. Think about the students that keep on roaming the streets. Think about the students that are renting in the informal settlement. Those that are working on the farms and being mistreated. Those that are working on premises of foreigners and being mistreated. Enough is enough. And as they say in that Tuaroloka, Tuako, Opuo, Kahepero, let's stand up together in unity and peace within the realms of our laws and march and shackle everything else that is not within our peace. Let's shake off the shackles of colonialism, of oppression, of corruption, and emerge once again in this beautiful, rich country as a nation truly free. The time has therefore come. All those that are part of this movement, the Dr. Panduleni Itula movement, phenomenon of change, to join arms and to ensure that when we march within the law, we organize all our activities within the law, we will not be the aggressor. However much they try to provoke us, however much they try to pull us out of our comfort of peace, let us not be the respondents to that. Let's march in peace and ensure when victory truly comes, we will celebrate. I wish you all a happy Christmas for those who are Christians and for those who believe in other religious sectors. I wish you all the best in the future. Let's march into the green fields of the year 2020, the year of general mobilization for final victory against the forces of corruption in Namibia and in the Swakopmund.